Hi, this is Ben Rogerson for MusicRadar.com at LIMS 2009. I'm here with Ollie Burke from Novation because they've managed to put their Automap software onto the iPhone. So, Ollie, is this a serious application or just a bit of a gimmick then?
I reckon it's reasonably serious actually. It's quite fun as well though, and that's half the point. So here's my lovely little Automap icon on my iPhone or iPod Touch. So it will find my computer. That'll be done very quick. So in my Ableton session, if I want to access this Novation filter, we press the effects button. There are the effects that I've got and the Novation filter. And I've just set something very simple up and very easily. Here's our cutoff control, resonance, and I'm just going through my filter types. This has also got a learn function, so we can actually learn stuff from the iPhone as well. So we'll just learn another control. I press learn, and I'm going to have to go to the computer. We've got a control, touch, and now our new parameters learn to the iPhone. We've also got a view window, which you can do it. You can, so the view window opens and closes our software screen. And if we go back to the browser, here are all our extra controls. User we can use for MIDI control, so this can be a bit more fun for live. So we've now mapped various CC numbers, which I've now used to scroll up and down my live set, and this CC to play. So when I press play, the session will start. So we can actually control our entire live set from our iPhone using MIDI, or control our VST or AU or RTAS effects and instruments from here.
So you imagine this being used by performers to play an entire live set?
You could use this as part of your control rig. You can actually, for those of you who've got more than one iPhone or more than one iPod Touch, use multiples at the same time. Yeah, there could be some collaborative music making event where everyone can turn up and have control over a different part of the software. Yeah. And like I say, you know, using it to start and stop clips in live is quite a useful application for it as well.
Sounds good. So when can we expect to see this in the App Store then?
It's going to be in the App Store fairly soon, and the price is going to be fairly low, but we don't have the details yet. So.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you.